Hello friends, welcome to a new chapter today. In this chapter, we are going to learn about autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease. Autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease, it is most commonly seen in infants and children. Okay, here there is mutation in gene PKHD1 on chromosome 6. And this PKHD1 encodes polydactin or fibrocystin, which is a multi-domain transmembrane protein. What does this polydactin do? This polydactin helps in cell-to-cell and cell matrix interactions. Okay, this polydactin is found in these areas. That is, cortical. It is mainly found in cortical medullary. It is found in cortical and medullary collecting duct. It is found in ascending loop of thick ascending limb of loop of Henle, in kidney, biliary and pancreatic duct and epithelia. So there are cysts present in these areas because of polydactin impairment. So there will be development of cysts in these areas. Okay, so this is called polycystic autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease shows something called as compound heterogeneity. Then if we see the clinical features, in the clinical features, first there will be cysts in the kidney, and these cysts in the kidney are seen in the intrauterine life. Because these cysts are seen in the intrauterine life, sometimes there can be presence of renal failure before birth itself. Okay, because of renal failure before birth, there will be decreased urine production in the mother's womb. So this decreased urine production, if you remember, the urine is the main constituent of amniotic fluid. But here, because of decreased urine production, this causes oligohydramnios. If you see, this oligohydramnios will lead to underdeveloped lungs. Why? Because if you see in this, this is the womb, okay? Here, this is the baby. Whenever there is oligohydramnios, there is increased chances whenever there is oligohydramnios, there are two things. One, this uterine wall, which is there, that will push pressure over the fetus. Thus, because of that pressure over the fetus, that will lead to the developmental anomalies, because this amniotic fluid will normally function as a cushion around the fetus, protecting it. But here, because of the loss of the cushion around the fetus and uterine pressure, will lead to developmental anomalies, which include club feet, flattened nose, wrinkled skin, widely separated eyes, and low set ears. So this is called as Potter's facies. Okay, then for the proper development of lungs, amniotic fluid is essential. But here, due to the decreased amniotic fluid, this leads to underdeveloped lungs, that is pulmonary hypoplasia, thus leading to respiratory insufficiency. So these are the complications which you see in polycystic kidney disease, autosomal recessive. So this is the image of Potter's facies which you see. You have here, there is club feet, and then you see flattened nose. And this is the low set ears which you are seeing. Okay, wrinkled skin here. Okay, and the widely separated eyes, that is hypertelorism, and there will be low set ears. So these are the features which is seen in Potter's facies. Okay, and if you see, by from birth itself, there is increased chances of developing renal disease from birth, and by 10 years of the age, the baby lands up in end stage renal disease. So because here in this polycystic kidney disease, urine concentration ability has been impaired, thus leading to metabolic acidosis. And as I have already told you, this polydactin gene, which is responsible for all this, is present in the kidney, and along with that, it is also present in biliary system and pancreatic duct. Because it is present in kidney, biliary system and pancreatic duct, there will be manifestations in biliary system and pancreatic duct also. So in the biliary tract and liver also, there will be cysts which are seen, and this cysts will lead to a condition which is called as congenital hepatic fibrosis in almost all the individuals. In all the children, there will be congenital hepatic fibrosis, which will at the end lead to portal hypertension, and this portal hypertension and this fibrosis leads to compromised blood flow. So you will see all the features of portal hypertension, like esophageal varices. You will see the concepts of the symptoms of portal hypertension, like esophageal varices, upper GI bleeding, splenomegaly, and hemorrhoids are seen in this polycystic kidney disease, autosomal recessive. This is also associated with this Caroli's disease. Okay, so if you do an ESG, how are you going to diagnose it? Diagnosis is by USG. Ultrasonography, if you see large echoic kidney. You see large echoic kidney, which is seen after 24 weeks of gestation. You will see this large echoic kidney, where the cysts are also seen in the kidney itself. Then, grossly, you will see that the kidney is bilaterally enlarged. And if you see the gross examination, you see the kidney is bilaterally enlarged with smooth external surface. And remember, if you remember, in polycystic kidney disease, autosomal dominant, the external surface is lobulated. But here, external surface is smooth and the kidney is normal in shape. Here, the cysts, if you see, there will be fusiform in shape and cylindrical. They are like this, and they are cylindrical cysts are seen. Okay, which are radiating from the medulla and extend into the cortex. Okay, so here you see small fusiform cysts which are cylindrical in shape, radiating from cortex, radiating from the medulla and extend into the cortex. Okay, so this has sponge-like appearance. Then I will show you the pictures also. Normal parenchyma, here the most important catchy feature is, here there is no normal parenchyma at all. But if you see in autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, normal parenchyma is seen. Okay, then if you see microscopically, you see that the all the glomeruli here are dilated. Glomeruli are dilated, and the cysts are also show dilated collecting tubule lined by cuboidal and low columnar epithelium. You see the cysts are lined by cuboidal and low columnar epithelium, and the collecting tubules are also dilated. Okay, so this is the one which is seen in autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease. Then we have two types of cysts. If you see the cysts, we have two types of cysts are present. That is, if in around 30% of the patients, you will see only cysts. Okay, in them, in these children, by adolescence, they reach to the they also cause congenital hepatic fibrosis. And among this 30%, 3% will survive for more than 20 years, and even then they reach congestive heart they will lead to chronic kidney disease. So by 20 years of age, most of these patients will reach chronic kidney disease, whereas if you see the other 70% of these children will have uterine cysts itself, and there is pulmonary hypoplasia and Potter's facies, and thus they die within 1 year. So if you were asked what is the most common cause of death in autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease, that is pulmonary hypoplasia. But in autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, the most common cause of death is chronic kidney disease. Okay, now I will show you the gross and microscopic pictures. So if you see, this is the normal kidney, this is normal, and here you can see the kidneys which are, you know, enlarged, and they have smooth glistening surface, right? The surface is completely smooth. So here if you see autosomal recessive kidney, and here you see enlarged, bilaterally massively enlarged kidney, and here you see the, this is the kidney, and even here the baby has died due to pulmonary hypoplasia. Okay, then this is the picture of ultrasound where you see many small cysts. You can even see clearly many small cysts. Then if you see, this is the picture of polycystic kidney disease, which is a cut surface where you see numerous glistening cysts of 1 to 2 millimeters in diameter, and they are uniformly distributed throughout the parenchyma, leading to spongy appearance. Here you see the spongy appearance, right? Next, this is the microscopic picture where you see numerous cysts which are elongated, and these cysts are lined by low columnar or cuboidal epithelium. Okay, then we have, this is the picture of an enhanced picture, especially this is autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease, which is showing congenital hepatic fibrosis. So all this picture which you are seeing here is fibrosed part. Okay, so this is the picture of congenital hepatic fibrosis. And what is this? This is the radially enlarged portal ducts. Okay, and around it, so surrounding this is the normal liver parenchyma, only this is the part of hepatic fibrosed part. Okay, so these are the different pictures about the polycystic kidney disease, autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. In the next class we will learn about one more important thing. Thank you.